All right, looks like we're going for the Dutch angle on this one for the intro. Hello, YouTube. Good afternoon. It's a lovely, sunny, blue sky kind of day. I like that. Might be the last one of 2021, though. If you're anything like me, you've got some tube maps at home, though, which you've probably looked at recently and thought, do you know what? Since TfL went out west, there are now 7 stations on the tube map with the word Acton in the title. And I just really want to know, how quickly can I get round all 7? What is the fastest time I can do all 7 Acton stations? So there's a map here. So you've got East Acton, North Acton, West Acton on the central line. You've now got Acton Main Line and TfL Rail, Acton Central, which is where I am now, and South Acton on the overground. And over here on the district of Piccadilly, you've got Acton Town. But it wouldn't be a Jeff video without a map that I've drawn and narrated myself, like this.
Yes, here's an accurate geographical map showing where the 7 Acton stations are in relation to each other. There's 2 on the overground, there's Acton Town on the district and Piccadilly, 3 on the central line, and then the awkward outlier that is Acton Main Line, currently part of TfL Rail, that would eventually be part of the Purple Train. And I've set myself some rules to abide by as to how I shall tick off these stations.
So the rule quite simply is, if you want to try this challenge yourself, which I suggest you do, you must arrive or depart at all 7 stations on a train. So I'm going to depart here at Acton Central, and I'll finish, I suspect, somewhere on the central line by arriving on a train, and I'll tick off the other 5 in between. Do all 7? 7. And I reckon, if I start on this one, the 1532, I can do it in just under an hour. So that's 2, or is it 3 minutes in? Easy. First one done, Acton Central. It's literally a 90 second journey down to South Acton. From here, gonna walk to the Piccadilly line / District Line station, Acton Town, which is about a 10, 15 minute walk in that direction. And I do want to pick up a District Line train that'll take me down to Ealing Broadway.
Now at this point, I was keeping an eye out for the 4:40 bus that I know runs along here, but alas, nothing. There was no bus coming.
So no bus for me, even though it just would have been one stop, would have saved me a couple of minutes, but ironically, obviously, there's one going in the other direction. Not helpful, but I can see the underground ahead, so we are close. Ealing Broadway train in 4 minutes, which is good. That should put me on time for a swift connection onto TfL Rail Purple Train to take me to Acton Main Line, where I will then do another bit of walking. Good so far.
Checking the live time of trains, my planning has meant that I've timed this right to pick up a train to Acton Main Line with a minimal connection time.
The next station is Ealing Broadway, where this train
turns. It is so sunny, here comes my train. I've timed this well, the 1601 is coming in, because Acton Main Line only gets an every half an hour stopping pattern. When I was planning this route, I did actually think I would have to start or finish at Acton Main Line, as it's like the oddity, it's the one out by itself. But then I realised that you can walk between here down to West Acton, and might even get a little sneaky bus as well. I just remembered I don't know the exit positions, because it used to be at that end, and now there's the new exit entrance. Oh, I think it's about halfway down. Also, I don't know if it's a 7 or 9 car. Oh, I can see it's a 9 car. 9 car purple train.
TfL Rail service to Addington.
So we go one stop to Acton Main Line, and the trick then is to walk down the road, down Knoll Road, and get to the central line that way. And again, it's about a 10, 15 minute walk, but there might be a bus that can take it for one stop, so we'll see how it goes.
Next station, Acton Main Line.
I should have been further down the train. That's fine, that's fine. We'll make it.
Thank you.
All right, out of Acton Mainline Station. Google Maps saying it's an 18-minute walk. 18 down to West Acton. I reckon I can walk it in 15. I was going to say it's got a 4:40 bus, but I've checked and the 4:40 bus has changed into the 218. Bus people, when did they split the 4:40 so that it became the 218? I was not aware of this. It's the 218 bus stop. 218, that used to be the 4:40. But it's in 8 minutes. I might as well just walk it. I could even do a little... You're allowed to run, by the way. The rule is, obviously, any form of scheduled public transport, train, bus, and your own feet. But whether that's at walking speed or on jogging speed, it's up to you. I'm thinking of having a little small run. It's 4:17, exactly 45 minutes in, approaching West Acton now, so it's just a matter of how long I have to wait for a train and tick off the last three. This will be under an hour. I can't see that in the bright sunshine. Okay, yes I can. You can't see it, but that does say 4 minutes. Check this out. Eastbound trains not stopping at East Acton between August and... Hang on. No! No, that's me now. Oh no. I did not know. Oh, you're kidding me. Oh no. Well, that's annoying. I genuinely didn't know that was a thing. My train's about to not stop. It'll stop at North Acton, and then it'll get to East Acton, and presumably it'll slow down and not stop. So I will make a note of the time then, but then to actually do it properly and get out at East Acton, I'll have to go to White City and reverse, and that will add 10 minutes to my time. Do you remember a few minutes ago when I was being all cocky? This will be under an hour. That's now not gonna happen. Well, it depends upon the rules. Oh man. That makes for a fun video, for goodness sake.
And so the train didn't stop at East Acton. It went along through North Acton just fine, tick that one off, but on approaching East Acton it slowed down, didn't stop, got a great view of all the building works of where they're rebuilding the platform on the eastbound side, and then had to carry on to White City.
So that's East Acton at 4:29, which would have been 57 minutes. So it is possible in 56, 57 minutes, because it slowed down a bit. But now I have to reverse at White City. That's so unfair. And that will take me over an hour. Great. Fortunately, another one just pulled in. It's a West Ryslip stopper in 2 minutes or 1 minute. So that will leave in 1 minute and I'll get there in about an hour and 5 minutes. So as my train departs, I just arrived on, checked my watch, it's 4:36, including the double back at White City. That took me 1 hour and 4 minutes. Trains not stopping on the eastbound platform here at East Acton, which I had no idea was a thing. So there we go, injected a little bit of fun, a little bit of drama. So if you want to do this, maybe wait until the works here are finished. The other obvious way to do it would be to start your journey here. Do the same route that I've just done, but do it in reverse and time it so that it hooks up with a purple train at Acton Mainline. So maybe start your journey at East Acton, head west, and do the whole thing in reverse. And you could definitely do it in under an hour. If you have a go, send me a tweet at Jeff Tech. Let me know. Otherwise, I would have gone under an hour. Oh!